So, Anna, if you want to pass, I advise you to let me help you. I don't need help. And if I do need help, I don't want him helping me. He's a freak, he's a weirdo, he's a dweeb. And if I'm seen with him in the hallways, you know what that would do to me? People will talk and gossip about it. And there's no way that I'm going to be the topic of the year. Joanna, do you want to graduate?
Of course I do. I want to graduate and get the hell out of the school more than anything.
Then he's going to tutor you.
Why can't my friend tutor me?
Who, Rachel?
Yes, Rachel.
Rachel can help you.
Why not?
Because Rachel is the type of person that likes to get her work finished and done. Okay, she's not going to want to explain to you. And you know she's not the type of person to explain anything to anyone. So, Jeremy is going to be kindly and nicely enough to tutor you and help you pass science if you want to graduate. Okay? There's only 2 months. 2 months and then you're gone. But you can't be gone out of here if you don't pass bio.
Fine.
I would like for you to start working together today on the homework that I assigned.
Okay. So at my house, like around 7?
Can't make it 7. I eat dinner at 7. My parents are very strict about eating dinner at the table. At 7.
Okay, then 8?
I'll see you at 8.
Alright then.
See you later, Joanna.
Yeah, whatever.
In a small town, and when the rain would fall down, I'd just stare out my window, dreaming of what could be, and if I'd end up happy, I would pray. Trying not to reach out, but when I tried to speak out, felt like no one could hear me. Wanted to belong here, but something felt so wrong.
You won't believe what happened to me last period.
What?
Miss Antonio paired me up with the nerdiest, dweebiest, disgustingest boy in the class.
And who's that?
You know who that is. Jeremy.
What?
Yes, Jeremy. She paired me up with Jeremy.
Can't you believe it?
Jeremy.
No, actually, I can believe it. I mean, he is the smartest kid in class. It would make sense for Mrs. Antonio to choose him to tutor you.
Anyway, you need to pass that class, because if you don't, you're not going to graduate with me up there on that stand. And I need my best friend there with me.
Am I hearing what I think I don't want to be hearing?
You're actually agreeing with Miss Antonio?
Not exactly agreeing with her. Just do whatever it takes to graduate, okay? I can't believe it. My own friend. Against me.
I'm not against you.
Listen, Jeremy isn't that bad of a guy. He's very nice. Maybe you should try being nice too.
No way!
Ding dong. Ding dong, ding dong.
Coming!
Stop it, Ginger. Go to your room.
Ginger,
go to your room.
Hello. Come on in. So, who are you?
I'm Joanna.
Well, I guess you're here for Jeremy then.
Yes, I am.
Well, I'm Samantha. Everyone calls me Sam. Jeremy's my brother.
He is. Wow, I didn't know he had a little sister.
Yep, that's me. Me and my brother Jeremy.
Thanks.
No problem.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Oh, it was no problem.
I hope my sister wasn't a bother. And I'm so sorry, I don't normally have her answer the door, but I was, you know, thinking. And usually I think in a room and I can't hear anything, so I'm sorry.
It's okay. Let's just get this over and done with. I really don't want to be here.
Okay. Well, read what it says.
It says, one of a cell's most intricate component is its cytoskeleton. To cytoskeleton is a network of protein fibers and tubes extending throughout the cytoplasm. So protein fibers and tubes or what extends throughout the cytoplasm.
Correct. You see, it's not that hard as you think it is. Science is really easy.
Easy for you to say, you're good at science.
Hey.
What do you want?
I want to talk to you.
There's nothing to talk about.
There's plenty to talk about. Can't just break up with me and walk away and expect me not to come find you. We love each other. We can't just quit on each other like that.
I'm not quitting, okay? I'm walking away.
Why? I love you. Do you understand that? I can't live without you. I need you. And I'm sorry that I haven't been there for you lately, but you have to give a man a break sometimes, you know? I mean, I haven't done anything wrong. I'm a very good boyfriend. When Valentine's Day comes up, I get you something. When our anniversary comes up, I never forget it. I will never forget the day I fell in love with you. Never. May 15th. 1999. I will never forget that. You were 15 years old, freshman. You were wearing this beautiful dress. And I could just remember just looking at you, walk down the hallways, and I just fell in love with you. I said, I have to ask this girl out. She's the hottest thing in school. You dress nice all the time. You were sassy, foxy, funny, and nice, and cute. Do you know how hard it is to find women like that? To even find a girlfriend as good as you? I would be damned if I just let you slip away. You're the girl of my dreams. And I'm sorry that I get jealous when you dance with other guys. But you have to know it's only because I love you so much. I guess so. I love you.